Hello all you zombies, welcome to Ant of Thigh's first Minecraft video. Let's get the show on the road. Now I'm here in my base on the Jadcraft server. It's a rather miserable day, so let's go over to spawn and turn off the rain. Just a quick look at my base, which is the Sky Islands. Up there, still coming into view, is the Iron Fog Golem, the Iron Golem Farm. The Jadcraft server was started by a good friend of mine, Jadea. I was one of the first players on his servers when he first started, and I rather enjoy it. Oh, and it's night time too. Okay. These here are some command buttons which help control things for the players on the server. And I'll be trying to show off some of the commands that are actually being used on the server. Now, first of all, let's just give a bit of a sleep. Okay. Now, this is a one-player sleep. That means even if there was more than one person, I'm the only one on the server at the moment, even if there was more than one person, only one player has to sleep to actually change it from night to time to day. There is a button over at spawn over there which can turn it back to night if that's what people want. Now, the command box is hidden. We're deep below spawn here. It's in a bedrock box, and the only way to access it is through our operational features. Now, I could go game mode 3 and fly down through the ground to it, but I've got this button here set up that allows me to get down there very easily. And here we are. Now, directly above us is spawn. I've got a few more buttons to allow me to get it back out easily. Now, I'm not op at the moment, so can't do anything, can't jump, can't fly, and so on. But on the other hand, I also cannot do anything and show command blocks. So let's op myself. Yes, I can be op. That's because I'm the administrator of the server. There is another player on the server who also has administrative privileges other than Jadea, who is the owner. Now, the first few here is just some basic game rules that are set up on the server just to stop too much verbose logging that the command blocks generally do. The rest of this little area here was one of the first mods that was used on the server. It basically is a torch removal mod. What I mean by that is after a set period of time, the torches would actually burn out. Now, it's been disabled now, so it's no longer in use. So, disabled. There are command blocks missing here, which is to actually set up the torch timers. This here is a fill clock. It basically powers the whole redstone line down there. Anywhere it sees a particular block, it will actually quickly switch it between redstone and normal stone. So these blocks here are actually running all the way down the line. This is a slow clock. One of these command blocks these command blocks are activated when the minecart hits the pressure plate. One of them kills the minecart, the other puts a new minecart up at the top. And then this one activates this redstone here. At the moment, however, of course, I've got it disabled through this switch, which constantly powers it, so it cannot get any more. So no torches get removed, even though it is there. This one, however, is still active because we do want to have the torch timers that are still in existence to be removed. This here is the second mod added, and it's basically an anti-Enderman griefing mod. This was created by the Hermitcraft crew, as was the next one. Basically, it gives the Enderman a invisible barrier block, so they cannot pick up any other block. And as such, if you look at an Enderman that is around the place, you'll see that they're holding their arms out. Let's see if we can actually pick up a Enderman. Hang on. Enderman. So if we spawn an Enderman, that's not an Enderman. Go away. That one. So if you look at him, he's actually holding out his arms. That's because in his arm, he's actually holding an invisible barrier block. If he puts down the barrier block is removed and he's given another one. So at no time can he pick up dirt, sand, pumpkins or melons or anything else that might cause a bit of griefing. So go away. Oh, I got a couple of pearls. Okay, it is a looting sword after all. Okay. This is... No, here we go. Over here, I believe. No. We have... yes, here we go. This is another Hermitcraft mod, and what it does is basically provide the one-player sleep. The first two buttons here is just to set it up, and then this provides a sleep. And what it does is when a player sleeps, it counts, does a countdown, and when it reaches zero, it sets the time to day, turns off the weather, and well, because it's day, everyone gets kicked out of their beds. This particular mod is one that I'm particularly proud of and had to expand, so it's there, a few more. So it's quite large, well, mediumly large. And what it does is provide a special mod for cutting wood. So if we have a line of timber attached, any old owl, doesn't matter, and we pick up get a golden axe. Now I'm just getting a golden axe. No, don't need that. I have actually already earned the achievement from the achievements mod for this, but if we throw it at the wood, it clears out all the wood. A little bit slow from the lag there. So, don't need that. Don't need that. Now, we're going to be needing to record some information. So we have here a mod, and there is a button up at spawn. Whoops, shouldn't do that. Put them back. Go up at spawn, which has the same function as this, and when you press it, what it does, that's not very nice of me. Hang on, let's get a button. When you press it, it basically brings up a sidebar that shows the current scores of various things that the player have done. So from this you can see that Future Jam has killed a lot of skeletons, which is not surprising considering he's actually got a skeleton spawner. And we have zombies, spiders, and they go all the way around. The pro is a new player, but he's got 39 deaths already. He has a tendency to die fairly easily, but he's learning. It's good for him. I've myself, as you can see from Antify there, it's got 8. I've got the most kills, probably because I've been roaming around the server in the wilds quite a bit. Jawbone has got quite a bit as well. I'm not certain what Jawbone has been doing to earn that many, but he's there. Toasty Pop has been also doing quite a few kills. The one that a lot of people try aim for when they're doing achievements is the wood. And as you can see, quite a few people about 6 or so people are above 7. 7 people are above 1,720 wood, which is the amount you need for a particular achievement. So let's just clear this. Again, there's another one of these buttons up in spawn, a pile. This is the achievement mods. from Toasty Pop, and it's on a very, very slow clock, even slower than this one. This has only got a, oh no, they've both got two webs. Okay. No, that's three webs, this is two webs. Okay, so it's slower than this one. What this does is actually count up the kills and of various monsters and give various achievements for reaching a certain number of kills. And one of them is the wood, both wood 2 and wood. And this gives you an achievement, and at the end gives you an axe, a timber axe. There are other achievements. For example, there is the Gil's helmet and a special shovel achievement for killing a lot of undead. So you could say you're burying the undead. This was the first few mods from the Game Mode 4 group. Game Mode 4 is a system by Accidental Games, run by Sparks and Crazy Man. It basically provides a whole system of mods that are easy to install and generally work together. This set is all about making mobs a little bit more dangerous, particularly the passive mods. So for example, squids will squirt ink. If you're underwater with the squid, it'll squirt out ink, blind you, and give you a little bit of nausea. Not very much, not very serious, but can be very distracting. Can give the squid a little bit of chance of getting away from a player after its ink sacs. The bat's grenades make bats explode with about a third of the force of a normal creeper, and is in itself a very big annoyance. They do have a tendency to explode through walls. So at some point along here, I've actually been next to the wall here and the bats have exploded on the far side. We also have undead players. These mods here are not quite exactly the same as the Game Mode 4 mods, because I installed them by hand after studying them. But they essentially do exactly the same thing. So they don't look the same, but they are the same. This one here is the Enderman support. What it does is it makes any mobs near an Enderman get extra powers. That is, creepers get regen, so they're a little harder to kill. Skeletons slow down the player, so the player gets a little bit more difficult to get up to the skeleton before the skeleton shoots them and knocks them back further. Zombies gets a speed boost, and a few other ones. You can look it up on Game Mode 4 if you want to see. But basically, any mobs around an enemy get a boost. So killing the enemy can be a good thing. This was one of the last ones that's been added, and it provides the better armor stand. Now, if we pick up an armor stand, let's see here. Get an armor stand. We get a few sticks as well, and we get some shears. Let's just put those away. So what it does is the player can put down an armor stand, doesn't matter quite where. If he throws shears at it, have to actually land on it. Okay, there we go. The armor stand shrinks. If you throw sticks at it, if you throw two sticks, it gives them arms. Very nifty. And of course, if you're not an op and you break it, you actually get your armor stand back, but you lose the sticks if you've added sticks. It's a very nice little system. The actual mod is changed, but the changes have not been published yet. The biggest command block mod that has been added is also from the Game Mode 4 mod packs, and that is this one. This is quite large, quite long, but it is very important. What it does is it starts with this little mod here, and all it does, this little bit here, all it does is allow you to craft one of these things. It's a dropper that contains a, inside of it there is an armor stand which is rotating because I'm close, and it's got a head of a workbench. So that's easily made. So let's actually pick up a little bit of equipment. So dropper, and oh, we'll need a workbench. So all you do is put down a dropper. It doesn't really matter what orientation it is. You put the recipe for the dropper inside it, and then you throw an armor stand on top, and there you go, you have a custom crafter. If it breaks, that device gives you a workbench table, but it's a slightly damaged one, just fairly nifty. So we'll just clear them out. That's all this does. It also creates a special armor stand, which you can add, and what that does is, if once a tick or so, it will turn this one into redstone. Now you're not seeing it flash here, but because one of these blocks immediately on seeing the redstone will set all of these ones to redstone, and the other one turns them all back into hardened stained clay. So you don't see it flash because it's flashing so fast, you just don't see it. But you can actually tell it is working if we get a command block. Oh, that's right, you cannot actually get it. You have to say give at P command block. So if we put a command block next to it there and have it say tell the nearest player, which is me, hi, you'll see that every so often it whispers to hi to you. So it's actually active. Now the first few here is the standard crafting rules that are provided by the standard custom crafting rules of game mode 4. This one, these three blocks, does two things. One, this bottom one is a recipe, and it basically is looking for a custom crafter that contains a certain pattern. This one replaces that custom crafter with the results, and this one plays a sound, and that's actually the order in which they run. So for example, if you put 9 flint in a custom crafter, you'll get 1 gravel. So let's actually show that flint, grab some flint, get rid of that now. So, and if we put that into a custom crafter, and there is a sound, you may not be able to hear it because of my recording software, but it does play a sound. And we get a block of gravel. You cannot put multiple in there. So if we do this, it does not work. We can do it to make pack ice, we can dye sand, we can pulverize sandstone blocks. So if we get a sandstone block and we stick it in the custom crafter, we get 4 sand. Same with any sort of sandstone block. There was something here to convert slabs to sand, but that is not really needed, because if you get some slabs and you put them into a normal workbench, you can actually create those blocks, and then you can actually convert them to sand. So really that's not needed. It was much more vital that we do other things with it up there. Webs, podzol, 2 different ways, various horse armors, and pulverizing quartz back into quartz shards, like so. These ones are recipes I've added to the standard crafting recipe, so it just continues on. So this block here is just, I could put a recipe in there, but I don't need to. This one here will convert hay and webs into sponge. These will pulverize stairs. This will add, we'll use them so that where this one creates a chiseled sandstone, this one, doing the same thing, will create normal sandstone. So you can, you, this will allow you to get the normal sandstone back rather than the chiseled, which is, I think, a much more important thing, because otherwise, once the sandstone becomes chiseled, it's very hard to get it back. The same thing with the various others. So this will convert smooth stone slabs back into smooth stone, and all the way along for the, in the same process. This one converts gravel to cobble, and this one converts cobble to gravel. Pulverized smooth stone to gravel, pulverized stone brick to gravel. So basically this provides a loop. So you can convert these things back to gravel, and then you can convert that back into cobble, where you can recreate what you need. So if you've got excess of these, you can actually form a loop and bring them all back. I haven't added any more, but I'm bound to add more recipes later. And that is basically the tour of the command blocks that were added. These, there is a lot of space in this command block box that will allow you to actually, that I can actually add a lot more of. There will be others, for example, lightning rods and better fire, that I do plan to add at some point in the future. Now I'm going to leave this box, and I'm going to do it by flying up. So if we go up and we leave the box, we can see here spawn is getting quite a mess. A lot of things actually roaming around. We've got stairs down to the slime farms, which I'm actually in the process of digging in survival. I don't cheat with that. And it's producing quite a good amount of slime, even though it's not complete. So if we have a look in the chest here, yes, that was actually cleared out about an hour ago. So it's actually working quite well. So let's just head up and get back to spawn. There is a button down there that could teleport me up here, but this is rather nice. Oh, sorry about that. Game mode 0. So on spawn, we've got a set of 5 command blocks, which is providing extra features to players. So underneath each of those is a command block. The players can't do it. I'm no longer op, so I can't even do it. You can't grab it. You can't destroy it. You can't explode it. And you can't see what the command is. But essentially, this will make it night. If I want to make it day again, I would have to go sleep in a bed somewhere. This will toggle the rain on and off, so in a moment it should actually start to rain. Come on. Are you going to rain or no, you're not going to rain? What's going on here? This is not right. Game mode 1. Toggle downpour. Yeah. Oh, it must be because I've cleared rain before. Ah, well. This one is the same thing that links to the command blocks box down below and turns on the cycling of the things on the side, and this just clears it when you're finished, because all players get that sidebar. There's not much I can do about that. It's just the way of that sidebar working. And that is a tour of the command blocks of spawn and my first Minecraft video. I hope this was very educational for you and to players of the server itself, and I hope that this will be the first of many such videos. So goodbye and have a good day.